Hello, welcome to online lecture of advanced survey. Today we are learn the type of curves used in road and railway engineering. There are two types of curve. First one is horizontal curve and second one is vertical curves. Horizontal curves further divided in four types. That is simple curves, compound curve, reverse curve and transition curve. And vertical curves is divided in two types, summit curves and valley curves. Let's see the details in curves. First of all, horizontal curve. The curves which are provided at turning point so as to get gradual changes in the direction of alignment of a road or a track are termed as horizontal curve. These curves are in horizontal plane. In railway track, the minimum radius of horizontal curve should be 175 meter for broad gauge. Horizontal as well as vertical curves in case of road must ensure safety, comfort and convenience of the traffic. Let's see the subtype of horizontal curve. First one is simple curve. The curve which consists of single arc of a circle of which two straight tangents further connected and brings about a deflection of the road through an angle theta is called as simple curve. For better understanding, we can see the figure. Simple curve is normally presented by the length of its radius or by the degree of curve. This type of curve is provided at every change in alignment of the road or railway track in a plain and in a hilly area. Next one is compound curve. A curve of having the series of two or more simple curves of different radii curving in the same direction is called as compound curve. For better understanding, we can see the figure. In compound curve, the two adjacent curves will have a common tangent BC as shown in figure. The center of two tangent curves lies on the same side of the curve as shown in figure. To avoid the cutting through the hard rocks, heavy cutting or filling in the alignment of the road or track, compound curves are provided. Next one is the reverse curve. The curve which consists of two simple curves having equal or different radii turning in opposite direction is called as reverse curve. For better understanding, we can see the figure. The two center of curve are an opposite side of a common tangent BD. Reverse curves are necessary on hill roads where frequently changes in the direction of travel are required. Reverse curves are also necessary for crossover in a station yard and in the alignment of railway track in a hilly areas. Next part is vertical curve. Vertical curves. The curves which are provided in the alignment of road or track at change of gradient is termed as vertical curve. The necessity of vertical curves is it is give the adequate visibility and safety to the traffic. It gives the gradual changes in grade or slope. It gives the adequate comfort to the passengers. The type of vertical curves is summit curve. The curve which are having convex surface on upward side is termed as summit curve. Vertical curves are very manly when rising gradient intersects a falling gradient or vein rising gradient meets another rising gradient or vein rising gradient meets a horizontal road or vein falling gradient meet at a steeper falling gradient. For better understanding, we can see the various situation of summit curves. First one is rising gradient intersecting a falling gradient. Next one, a rising gradient meeting another rising gradient. And third one is a rising gradient meeting at a horizontal road. Valley curve, the curve which are having the convex surface on downward side is termed as valley curve. For better understanding, we can see a falling gradient intersecting a rising gradient, a falling gradient meeting another falling gradient, and last one is a falling gradient meeting a horizontal road. Thank you. Thank you very much.